So after 1 to 2 minutes, we have now the final results, and we can see Out of Position has a kind of mixed strategy when it comes to the preferred bet sizing. 18.5% of small betting, 29% of potting. If we take a look at In Position, we can see a clearer strategy, more potting, less betting small, and a lot of checking as well. So I would say let's take a look at what Hero did, and then we take a look at what our actual play, GTO approved play, would have been. So Hero checks and faces the pot size bet, which we said that is pretty common. And Hero decided to call. So that was Hero's decision. So let's take a look at whether this was good or not. So going to the out of position player, I mean, we can start here with kings, and we can see pretty decent mix, mostly betting big, but yeah, a good mix between checking and betting big for the most part. And as soon as we add the ace, though, we see that this is a 100% check. So all the ace, king, king are checking here. And if we check and face the pot size bet, we are going to call. So check call here, the correct play. And yeah, this is pretty much, now we can filter with the MonkerSolver filters. But there is another cool thing that we can do now in Vision by using the custom mode. So let's get in Vision here. So we go to practice and select the custom mode. And we can see now a new interface. So we can pick a name here, for example, River, Heads Up, BB, Check versus Pot, something like this. Then we have the River pot size, which was 90. And the board I can just copy paste from the MonkerSolver. So copy paste. And now we need the PPT ranges, as you can see here. So what does this mean? How does this work? We bring back MonkerSolver, and now we can go ahead, click here on the fold and press copy to clipboard. We select range and PPT, just go copy to clipboard and cancel, go back to Vision and paste it in here. The same we are doing now for the other two ranges. So for the calling range, and then last but not least, for the raising range, which is, by the way, only 0.2%. So I'm just curious about our queen jack, and we can see our queen jack is pretty much always betting here, mostly for the big sizing, but we are pretty much never checking queen jack here, which is another interesting information. And yeah, then it makes it clear that we are pretty much never check raising here. But yeah, kind of a unique strategy, I would say. So yeah, pasting in the final line. And now we can go here to fold, call, and raise. Okay, so last but not least, we can set up the player bubbles. So we are here the hero. Out of position, we didn't bet. And in position has 155. Nope, that's not true. He bet. He has 65 and he bet 90. So this is the spot we are looking at. And now that we have set up everything, we can go to generate. And now we get a randomly generated hands of our range, and we have to decide what to do. So I think this is already an interesting one, given we are blocking the straight, we have two pair. We also have the hearts, so yeah, pretty close, I would say. Started with a fold, and we can see fold is correct with exactly the two hearts. So let's go for some more hands. Ace, king, 6-5. So definitely a stronger mate hand, but now we don't have the queen or a jack blocked. Going for a call, I think it's strong enough with the ace king, and it is. So king, king, 10-7, definitely a call. Ace, king, king, 3, definitely a call. Ace, queen, queen, 4, this is an interesting one. Now blocking the straight, very good, but pretty weak mate hands. I would say the straight blockers here are very important, and we take it as a call. So yeah, as you can see, we have the vision search engine here on the right, and we can also utilize the hands filter here on the left. So we can go and select different hands. So maybe let's find an interesting one where we are blundering. So ace 10, 9, 8 looks very close, but yeah, with the free pair, guess we can call. Nope, that's not correct. So I think we already found a good one. So let's apply this one. Top two. So yeah, I mean, top two is ace king and ace 10 in this case. We have the gut shot, which is pretty irrelevant for this spot. We have a high flush draw and we have no backdoor flush draw. And let's see this filter. And we can see we are folding more often than not, but still not entirely clear. So I think this is already a good one. And if we're now creating new hands, we can see that we are getting hands dealt like this. Interesting one as well, because we have the sevens, which are maybe not as relevant, because on the flop it went check, check. So we know ace 10 is usually a fold. The sevens might be good or bad. I'm not sure yet. So I go with the fold. And yeah, so the sevens not that relevant. And now I think with the check, this could be a good call. And yeah, this is exactly the case. Very close though. And if we take a look at the filter, I think the calling range will most likely be these ace 10 with a check, ace 10 with a queen. So if we have now ace 10, 8 deuce, I guess it's a fold. And ace king, yeah, ace king might be good enough itself. So going for the call here again. So yeah, I think we are figuring out the pattern here of this situation kind of well already. And here I would say we ended with a fold, and this is correct. So yeah, now we learned ace 10 needs queen or a check in order to call, ace king and better is strong enough to call them on its own. So yeah, so with this way you can practice your river sims, you can practice pretty much all the sims that you have on on your computer. So yeah, I hope you liked it, and see you in the next one.